今日姊妹平安，今天是六月十三，六月份第二的主日。感谢主，咱奉主的圣名，有当在空中，撒个来敬拜属咱的上帝。咱的上帝是无所不在的上帝，伊有当在礼拜堂接受咱的敬拜，也伫咱的厝内接受咱的敬拜。我们明白一个敬畏上帝的心，撒个来属奉敬拜咱的上帝。那撒个阿头伫主阿头前，好来祈祷，明白咱的心，将咱的智慧交到主的手的中间。感谢上帝保守君，好君今日有通结束，好来敬拜君的上帝。主啊，你是无所不在的上帝，特所在接受君的敬拜，帮助君，好君一个清洁的心来到你的头前，陪伴君的心，用敬畏上帝的心来敬拜君的上帝。主啊，君将今日君早起的崇拜交到主你的手中，愿主的圣灵来带领君早起的敬拜，愿以荣耀颂赞荣归在主你的里面。帮助你的家里用心灵诚实在你的头前来敬拜你，因为你是属灵的上帝。你跟这个撒玛利亚妇人说，敬拜上帝的人应该用心灵诚实来敬拜你。君将所落去的时间交到主你的手中，求主的圣灵来带领君早起对开始到结束的聚会，愿你的名在我们的中间得到真正大的荣耀。祈祷交托奉告主耶稣基督的圣名， Amen。你这边大家用西瓜来阿罗那的上帝，you
Crushed by the weight of sin, Jesus is calling. Have you come to the end of yourself, to the thirst for a drink from the well? Jesus is calling. as you wait for the crown. Tell the world of the treasure you found.
Hello, 姐妹平安。
Peace to you, brothers and sisters.
那个了，各种描述上智慧人生的蓝图，这个系列的信息。
Once again, we'll continue the sermon series "Blueprint for a Life of Wisdom."
今天的看的经文是《传道书》第十章。
Our passage for this day is found in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 10.
我的题目是《愚人的道理》。
Portrait of a Fool.
传道书第十章，愚人和愚人一摆一摆出现。
In this chapter, chapter 10 of Ecclesiastes, these words folly and fool appeared time and again.
中文圣经出现了九次。
The Chinese translation, it appeared 9 times.
你若看 NIV 的圣经出现了八次。
If you refer to the NIV translation, you'll see it 8 times.
所以我叫传道书十章叫做愚人的道理。
This chapter was appropriately called Portrait of a Fool.But we need to understand the fool which the Bible calls is different from what we usually mean by the term. What do we mean when we say fool? You may say the person is stupid, slow to react, or lacking in knowledge, or having very poor learning ability.
So it's IQ.
You can say that person possess very low IQ.
但在地位者里面，戆不是讲伊 IQ 真低，是讲伊创的代志在上帝目中真戆。
However, in this book of wisdom, a fool does not mean the man has low IQ, but instead, it indicates that in God's eyes, his deeds are all foolishness.
这款人在世界可能真早聪明。
Maybe.This person might appear to be wise in the world. However, before the eyes of God, he is a fool.
現今世界有一款叫做低能的犯罪犯罪犯。
In today's world, we're familiar with a term called intelligent criminals.
這款人的 IQ 是非常的高。
These criminals, they possess very high IQs.
最近香港發生這樣的事。
Recently, something like this happened in Hong Kong.
一個犯人被人騙了200 million 的港幣。
A woman was defrauded of 200 million Hong Kong dollars.
對方用這個電話跟他講，跟他講話。
And the other party simply used a phone call to communicate with her.
講這個人將一切伊的 information 給他知呀。
In the end, this lady divulged all her personal information.
Yeah, Hong Kong ID number.
Including her own Hong Kong ID number.
Yeah, 銀行的 number.
Her personal bank account number. The woman was informed that her account was used for money laundering. And not only that, this woman was provided with 10,000 Hong Kong dollars. The caller instructed her to purchase a brand new phone to avoid being eavesdropped.
所以这个人已经在相信这个是政府的电话卡来。
Because of such offer, the woman believed that the call was legitimate and appropriate from the government.
结果骗了200亿的港币。
In the end, she was defrauded of 200 million Hong Kong dollars.
这个人真在聪明。
And the criminals were so wise.
但是上帝目中是戆人。
But in God's sight, they are a fool.
传道书第十章就是戆人的道理。
And Ecclesiastes chapter 10 gives us the portrait of a fool. The first four verses, it talks about the heart of a fool. Verses 5 to 11, it talks about the hands of a fool. Verses 12 to 15, the mouth of a fool. Verses 16 to 20, the mindset of a fool. First, let's look at the first four verses.The heart of a fool. Let's read verse 1.
伊讲死的河神，河水旁的膏药发出臭气，安尼呢，一点仔眼光，和败坏智慧及尊严。
As dead flies give perfume a bad smell, so a little folly outweighs wisdom and honor.
所罗门突然创一个结论。
Solomon first gave us a conclusion.
伊讲死的河神和旁膏尖发出臭味。
The Dead flies will give perfume a bad smell.
香膏是真香的。
This perfume should be very fragrant.
但是有一只死的河神在里面。
However, if there's a dead fly included in that perfume,
总有一日这个香膏会发出真臭的味出来。
One day, this perfume will exude the foul smell.
伊讲同款。
In the same manner,
一个戆人总有一日发出臭臭味在这个世界里面。
Sooner or later, the fool will divulge or will manifest his bad odor.
破坏了人的荣耀，人的尊严。
And it will bring down a person's honor and glory.
几个月前
，few months ago，
咱听到这个未来撒加利亚的故事。
We received news about Mr. Ravi Zacharias.
这个真正好的证明。
It's a very good example or proof. How many people respected him? And many would like to have a picture or photo taken with him. And just because of something that he has done, it destroyed his honor and his wisdom. And his own organization had to change names. Indeed, we need to be careful. Let's look at verse
2.
The heart of the wise inclines to the right, but the heart of a fool to the left. May I ask, is your heart on the left or on your right side? Most of us, our hearts are on the left side.
So, we are fools.
And that's why we may be classified as fools. However, this is not what the Bible meant. It's not the physical position to explain this verse. Usually, the right side would connote value and honor.
单边 是代表轻看、无看重的意思。
While left side would signify contempt or insignificance.
你看马太福音第二十六章六十四节。
If you read Matthew 26 verse 64,
你讲总是我跟你讲，后来你看到连主借的官能者多边的差别啊？是right hand side or left hand side?
But I say to all of you.From now on, you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the Mighty One.
The right hand side.
Seated at the right hand side.
代表伊个尊贵的所在，尊贵的 position.
It means a place of honor and of significance.
你看 Book of Acts.
Let's read the Book of Acts.
这是 Stephen 被荷兰拍死前讲的一句话。
Stephen, before he was martyred, he gave this remark.
伊讲看，我搁到踢亏了。领主家的上帝 right side 的差别。
In Acts 7 verse 56, Stephen said, "I see heaven open and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God."
这个是 right hand 是代表尊贵的所在。
And similarly, right hand connoted position of honor and significance.
所以这段圣经真正意思是什么呢？
What does this verse mean?
你需要保守你家己的心。
It means that you need to be carefulAbout your heart. You need to put emphasis on your heart. In comparison, it's just like putting your heart in a very significant and important position. If you take a look at the book of Proverbs, chapter 4, verse 23. Above all else, guard your heart.For everything you do flows from it. This heart would include our thoughts, our feelings. A fool will never guard his heart. And in the end, verses 3 and 4 will happen. Even as fools walk along the road, they lack sense and show everyone how stupid they are. If a ruler's anger rises against you, do not leave your post.Calmness can lay great offenses to the rest.
第三则是讲到这个戆人无 direction 无方向感，唔知去得落。
In verse 3, we were told that this fool has no direction and he doesn't know where to go.
第四则讲这个戆人没有保守自己的情绪，自己 emotion.
And verse 4 explained how this fool could not control his own emotion.
你看第三则。
Let's read verse 3.
伊讲戆人唔知去得落。
The fool doesn't know where he's headed to.
因为他没人生的方向。
Because he has no direction in his life.
你根本不知道这个世界要创什么事情。
He doesn't even know what he is supposed to do on earth.
你哪知道，那个教会有，那个叫做教会的宣言，这个mission statement.
We all are familiar with our church mission statement.
所以教会知道教会创什么事情。
And that's why the church is very clear about its mission and what he has to do.
请问。
May I ask?
你知你家己人生宣言是做什么
？Do you know your own personal life's mission statement？
你若唔知呀，你的 mission statement， 你的 personal statement 创什么
？If you do not have your own personal mission statement， then you will not know what to do。
我嚟知呀，我的 personal mission statement。
May I share with you my own personal mission statement？
接着正义分条上帝道，以宣讲上帝真理，以神作旨的教导。
By accurately analyzing and interpreting the word of God, preaching the truth, teaching by example, and discipling all men to become followers of our Lord Jesus Christ.
This is 我个人的宣言。
Above is my own personal life's mission statement.
所以我知影我哋世界最什么款嘅代志。
I know what am I supposed to do on earth.
戆人唔知要做什么代志。
Fool, on the other hand.They do not know what to do. Neither can they control their own emotions.
So, the sixth is saying what?
And in verse 4,
he says, "In 长官的头前，你唔通受气就离开."
And that's why we were told in verse 4 that do not leave your post. If a ruler's anger rises against you,
伊就讲当你的头家生气的时阵
，which means that when your superior is mad at you,
戆人未晓用温柔的办法去面对。
A fool will not be able to address or face the issue with calmness.
伊的方法就是 quit 离开。
Oftentimes, these people will just quit and leave.
咱中间做头家的。
And people who are bosses in our midst.
你有安尼款的经验无？
Have you experienced such situation?
甲你下下人讲一句话，还是生气讲一句话
？Sometimes when you admonish your employee with a word or two,
伊生气
，the employee will get mad.
我头就走。
And this employee will file his or her resignation and quit.
我甲你讲，即款的人哦，也是免留了啦。
Let me tell you this: such employee, you need not.Retain or persuade them to keep.
这个人对你的公司啊，的确唔是一个真大祝福嘞。
They will not do your company any good.
这是戆人的心。
And that's the heart of a fool.
好，第二。
Second.
你来讲戆人的手。
Let's look at the hands of a fool.
5-11
Verses 5-11.
这个手是指的行为。
The hand would refer to a man's conduct.
那这七章的圣经的里面。
And in the following 7 verses.
讲到戆人人格的表现。
We shall.Provide you how this fool in two different traits.
第五到第七节
First, in verse 5-7,
讲到这个戆人有一个真，这个价值观真乱啊。
This fool has a mixed up value system.
你看第五到第七节
Let's read verses 5-7. There is an evil I have seen under the sun, the sort of error that arises from a ruler. Fools are put in many high positions, while the rich occupy the low ones.I've seen slaves on horseback while princes go on foot like slaves.
In the
English, there's a saying,
意思讲，上牛画了这个价格的标签吗？
Who switched the price tag?
一百块变成一千块。
That 100 becomes 1,000.
一千块变成一百块。
1,000 would be erroneously labeled as 100.
所以这边的价值大乱个。
So here we can see how messed up the value is.
这则圣经讲，戆人的。拐的位置的里面，尊贵人伫下真低的 position 的里面。
Fools who are placed in high position, while noblemen are in low position.
仆人伫坐咩？王主伫头头伫对照去行路。
Slaves are on horseback, while princes they go on foot like slaves.
这个呢，情况何人知呀？
This situation allows us to see.
规个价值观完全乱去啊！
The entire value system was messed up.
唔应该出现的现象出现咯。
Situation that ought not appear appeared.
箴言第30章21-33是最好的解释。
Proverbs chapter 30 verses 21-22 provided us with a very good explanation.
伊讲好对顶当有三项代志，连对都答未起，有四项代志。第一，仆人最戆；第二，戆人食饱；第三，真歹看、真恶毒的富人人出家；第四，比如接罪祖庙。
Under three things, the earth trembles. Under four, it cannot bear up. First, a servant who becomes king. A godless fool who gets plenty to eat. A contemptible woman who gets married. And finally, a servant who displaces her mistress.
四款的情况。
These are the four different scenarios.
仆人变成王啊。
A servant who eventually become a king.
戆人无去追工，搁食饱饱。
This fool who is so lazy and will not work and yet has plenty to eat.
搁真歹看，搁心真恶的女主，搁嫁出去。
Contemptible, ugly, wicked-hearted woman finally get married.
出来，你工人这个白色工，你完了，变做你，变做你头家了。
Servant or your house helper eventually become your mistress or the boss wife.
这龙族不应该发生的代志。
Things like this should not have happened.
结果发生了咯。
And yet it do.
伊讲对对叮当啊。
And it will cause the earth to tremble.
因为这个价值观乱起啊。
Because the entire value system was so messed up.
第二呢？
Second,
第八到十一节
verses 8-11,
是讲到这个管理模式乱去。
It talks about the chaotic management style. In these four verses between verse 8 to verse 11,
这本章两方面来看,
we can subdivide this into two different areas.
第八节,
verses 8 and 9, it talks about the reverse side of teaching.
第十九节,
while verses 10 and 11 is the positive approach.
好,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来,来
pit may fall into it. Whoever breaks through a wall may be bitten by a snake. Whoever quarries stone may be injured by them. And whoever splits logs may be endangered by them. In these two verses, four different actions were described. Digging a pit. Breaking a wall. Quarrying stones. And splitting logs. People who dug a pit was for the purpose of catching the wild animals. In the end, this person fell into this pit. Usually, if you break down an old wall, it's in order to build up a new one or a new structure. And in the end, this person gets bitten by a snake. There are snake holes or snake pit under the wall. Quarrying a stone, but in the end, this person got injured by the stones. Splitting the logs, and in the end, he hurt his own feet. What is Solomon talking about? These four activities are considered to be dangerous to do. It means that the fool will have no previous prior preparation or consideration. Because he did all of this in a haste. And this fool does not take into account safety measure or protocol. In the end, he ended up injured. If you explain this in current situation, you will understand this very clearly. By the end of April of this year, the COVID cases in India increased significantly.
Every day is 30,000 to 40,000.
Approximately 300,000 to 400,000 cases a day. Within 1 week, millions were affected by this COVID-19. You may ask, why so serious? It seems that there was no plan and no specific strategy in place. While the pandemic was at its height, millions even participated in religious activities. It's a model of chaotic management. How do you resolve or how do you address this? Verses 11 and 12. Verses 10 and 11 provided us with a positive approach and right teaching. It showed us how we are supposed to face or address these issues. Of course, we are not saying that this fool that we are referring here is a person who does not have IQ. The question is, are they willing to consider others' opinion or are they willing to listen? Let's read chapter 10, verse 10. If the axe is dull and its edge unsharpened, more strength is needed, but skill will bring success. And this verse teaches us something very important. If the edge of the axe is already dull and you will not sharpen it, then your effort will be wasted. There's a very Chinese saying that provided us with a very good explanation. If a worker wants to be good at his craft, he must first sharpen his tools.
这个axe若真对了，你若无开起来哦，实在了你的困难啦。
Unless the workman would sharpen his saw or his tools, then all the effort will be wasted.
用现在话来解释,
in today's explanation,
你的公司的computer已经是20年前的computer。
If you are still using computer system or software which are 20 years old,
你的公司创造的效率的确真真万大家。
The efficiency and the output from your company will be very low.
你需要改变。
You need to change.
不要用古早前的物件来做现在的工作。
You should not use software from the past in order to solve the tasks of the present.
你看第十一节。
Let's read verse 11. If a snake bites before it is charmed, the charmer receives no fee.
用另外一句汉文来解释。
If you explain this in another Chinese saying,
叫做未雨绸缪啊。
Prepare for a rainy day.
雨没落来，雨伞已经备办了咯。
Before there's a rainfall, you should prepare your umbrella.
另外一句话,
and another saying,
叫做预防胜于治疗啊。
Prevention is better than cure.
所以咱一切物件都有这个要备，真正备办，备办好些门啊。
And that's why in everything that we do, we should have adequate and correct preparation.
你看现今这个世界面对这个 COVID 的 situation.
As we face the present COVID situation,
多一个国家比较早有备办、较早有安排的问题较少淡薄。
The countries that prepared adequately will have lesser problems.
美国是全世界第一进步其中一个国家。
United States is considered one of the most advanced countries in the world.
但是真奇怪。
But surprisingly,
美国是 COVID 开始第一严重的国家。
It became one of the most severe COVID-related country in the world.
原因只有一个,
there's only one reason.
根本没有备办,
there was no preparation.
所以求主帮助咱,
and the Lord help us.
咱常常说成功是好这款备办好的人。
Oftentimes, we would say that success goes to those who are prepared.
当然咱属上帝的人应该加一句话。
We who belong to God must add to this saying.
给就上帝祝福。
We need to acknowledge that the blessings is from the Lord.
但是你若完全没有备办,
however, if we're not prepared at all,
上帝没有祝福咱呢?
How can God bless us?
这两节圣经,
and in these two verses,
让咱知道,戆人没有听人的教导。
It tells us simply that the fools refuse to listen to teachings of wise.
戆人创的事,
and whatever the fool will do,
都是照自己爱做什么就去做什么,
in accordance to what he wants to do.
不听人的意见,
and he refused to consider others' opinion.
这个叫戆人的手,
and that is the meaning of the hand of a fool.
第三,
third,
你说戆人的嘴,
let's look at the mouth of a fool.
12到15节,
and you'll see this in verses 12 to 15.
这四节的圣经的里面,
and in these four verses,
让咱知道戆人的嘴,
it tells us what kind of word that would come out from the mouth of the fool.
头一句话,
the first,
叫做破坏性的话,
words of destruction.
你看第十二节,
let's read verse 12.
他说,智慧人的嘴说出恩言,戆人的嘴吞灭自己。
Words from the mouth of the wise are gracious, but fools are consumed by their own lips.
智慧人, 出来吹的话都是稳定的话。
Words from the mouth of the wise are full of grace.
但是戆人的吹的话都是破坏性的话。
And the fools would often blurt out destructive words.
结果连家己都destroy去。
In the end, the fool will get destroyed himself.
圣经里面有一个人叫示威。
And in the Bible, there's a man called Shimei.
这真好的example.
Shimei in the Old Testament provided us with a good example.
他自己会destroy自己的生命.
His own word eventually destroyed his life.
那时候, Absalom 去背叛 David.
During that time, Absalom was in rebellion against his father, King David.
所以 David 只要无法落，忽然间赶紧离开Jerusalem.
During that time, David has to escape and flee for his life from Jerusalem.
So Shimei took this opportunity to save David.
And Shimei took this opportunity to curse David. He cursed David by saying, he says, you murderer, you scoundrel.
去啦,
get out, get out.
你现在自己吃自己的灾难啊。
And now all the blood you shed in the household the Lord has repaid on you.
所以地位其实无办法。
During that time, David has no place to go.
他暂时帮这个示妹出去。
Temporarily, he let Simei get away with his act.
但是大卫记得示妹出去讲的每一句话。
And yet, David remembered every word that Simei cursed him.
当大卫准备离开世界的时候
，When David was about to leave this world,
他叫伊家所罗门来。
He called his son.Solomon, and he said, you should never consider that Shimei was without fault. You are a wise person, and you will know what to do with him. And Solomon devised a way to bring Shimei's gray head down to his grave. And Shimei's deathwas exactly by the words he spoke. Second, the words of a fool are arrogance and madness. If we read verse 13, at the beginning, their words are folly. At the end, they are wicked madness.From the start until the end, the words of a fool are all wicked madness and folly. Because the fool considered himself to be outstandingly very important. This three character means that you are very important, you are very outstanding. Very important and outstanding. However, if you read these three characters in the opposite direction, it means that you cannot even stand up. Initially, you are outstanding. In the end, you are so insignificant that you cannot even stand up. And we need to be humble as a person. We should not be proud. And when Moses was talking to Pharaoh, he said, The Lord our God says, Let my people go. You know how Pharaoh replied? Who is the Lord?Why should I obey him? I do not know the Lord. I will not let the Israelites go. Pharaoh thought that he was somebody great and so important. Who is the Lord Jehovah? Why should I listen to him? When the world listened to what I say, why should I listen to him?A man's pride. The entire Egyptian empire was ruined. The third type of words. Words of the fool lacking in restraint. Let's read verse 14. And fools multiply words.No one knows what is coming, and who can tell someone else what will happen after them? It means that the fool likes to talk. In order to show that he knows something, that he has some knowledge and he has some wisdom. He is so afraid and so scared that others will not know. That's why in every occasion, in all meetings, the fool needs to say something. He wanted others to hear his voice. But do you know? A half-filled pale. You know, if a person has a full bucket of water, whenever the person carries this pail, there will be no sound from this bucket or from the pail. Because the bucket or the pail has no more space left.
所以无，因为水哦无法发出声音起来。
And the water movement will not create much noise.
但这个水的里面，那个水那是一般。
However, if this bucket or the pail is only half filled,
你若跳起来夹的时阵，
whenever a person would carry this bucket,
也就声音会发出来。
You will hear the splashes, the sound of the splashes.
因为收个水。
Because there's still space inside that bucket. And that's the way with the fool. The fool loves to talk. Because this person is not completely filled inside. You cannot say that this person is so empty, but he has something inside. His knowledge, the words that he spoke of, will not be accurate. And that's why the fool, they love to talk. But they are not aware, or he does not realize what he has spoken. And he does not even know what will happen in the future. That's why Proverbs has this very appropriate saying. Even fools are thought to be wise if they kept silent, and discerning if they hold their tongues.
第四样代志,
and fourthly,
妄人的嘴的话是无知, 就是ignorant无知的话。
The words of a fool are of ignorance.
你看第十五节,
Let's read verse 15.
凡妄人也落入家己的困惑，因为连真实的路他都不知啊。
The toil of fools wearies them. They do not know the way to town. What do we mean by the way into the town? It means that it's the way where you will take in going home. That's a basic direction that one has to know. And yet the fool is not aware. Maybe the fool has an Alzheimer. Do you know the meaning of this verse? It means that the fool only knows very little. And most of the time, his words will be unwise words spoken. The words spoken are neither beneficial to himself nor to other people. And the more he say, the more problem he will cause.
So you
say
more talk, more mistake.
More talk, more mistakes. In the Bible, an example was given by Jesus. The parable of the Fool rich man. The parable of the rich fool, he is telling himself many things. The rich man said to himself, I will build a larger storehouse. A larger barn to store all my grains and all my wealth. Then I will say to my own soul, I'll say to my own soul, eat, drink, and be merry. And what did God say to him? You fool. This very night, your life will be demanded from you. Then who will get what you prepared for? Ignorant words are this foolish words. Ignorant words are words that leave God out of the equation.
In God we trust.
We're all familiar with this saying, in God we trust. And those are very wise sayings. And these are the words where the founders of the United States of America has decided to put in their currencies or in their bill.
In God we trust.
In God we trust. But come to think of it. If you remove the word God, what shall you put on the blank?
In summit we trust.
In what will you trust?
In money we trust.
Do you trust your money?
In authority we trust.
Or do you trust your power?
In people we trust.
Or do you trust somebody? I do not know what you believe in, but let me tell you, anything that will take the place of God will be considered as foolish words.
因为冇这个物件，冇这个物质，有当代替恁的上帝。
Because there's nobody nor anything could take the place of our God.
但是我那个最常常讲一关真正讲的话，无地的话。
However, the fool will often utter unwise words.
No me.
Finally,
你讲戆人的心态。
Let's take a look at the mindset of a fool.
十六到十九章
verses 16 to 19.
这三章的圣经。
In these three verses,
我们知影戆人有三款的心态。
Three mindsets or attitudes of the fool are presented.
第一
，first，
放纵。
The mindset of self-indulgence.
你讲第十六、十七章
verses 16 to 17.Woe to the land whose king is a child, and whose princess feasts in the morning. Blessed is the land whose king is of noble birth, and whose princess eat at a proper time for strength.
这两节圣经是个比较。
And these two verses provided us comparison.
智慧人跟戆人的比较。
The comparison between the wise and the fool.
智慧人、戆人都吃，都肯定吃，都肯定啉。
Both fool and the wise will need to eat.And drink.
但是为什么吃？为什么啉？
The reason for their eating, the reason for their drinking would vary.
智慧人吃为了补充体力。
The wise will eat in order to maintain health.
做更加好的代志，更加重要的代志。
That they may accomplish more and be more productive.
戆人吃是为了enjoy，为了宴乐去吃。
The fool, on the other hand, would eat to be merry and to enjoy.
你是为什么吃？为什么啉？
May I ask, for what reason do you eat and drink?
保罗讲，吃啉拢会荣耀咱的上帝。
Apostle Paul reminded that, whatever you eat or drink, it is for the glory of God.
十九世纪有一个也出名的传道人，叫 D.L. Moody.
In the 19th century, there was a very popular preacher by the name of Dwight L. Moody.
这个人比较较肥啦。
This person is quite heavy on the physical side, about 300 pounds. And he was criticized. And because of your size, because of your wealth, because of your weight, you might be a glutton. Moody replied, Even if I, D.L. Moody, I'm 300 pounds,But each and every single pound of me is for the Lord.
教会
Dear church,
请问你有几磅?
How many pounds are you?
你几磅是为主的?
How much of those are for God?
第二
Second,
第二的 mindset, 戆人的 mindset 是这个叫做贫惰 laziness.
The second mindset of a fool is of laziness.
你看第十八节
Let's read verse 18. Through laziness, the rafter sags. Because of idle hands, the house leaks.
这间厝内开始小关有一个空人，滴淡薄水落来。
Initially, your roof or the ceiling has a small hole of leak.
应该去修理。
And at that time, you need to fix the leak.
但是变多。
Because of laziness.
明仔日，明仔日。
Maybe I'll do it tomorrow.
但是明仔日又有另外一个明仔日。
But tomorrow has another tomorrow.
结果明仔日，又明仔日，又明仔日。
And you drag on, you procrastinate tomorrow after tomorrow. The small hole eventually turned to a big hole. And finally, the entire house collapsed. What does this tell us? It says that the fools, they are not unintelligent. It doesn't mean that they were oblivious or they have not seen the problem. They know that there's a problem here. Because of their laziness, because of their ignorance, they refuse to deal the problem. Do not want to solve the problem. And in the end, the problem becomes more and more serious. Anyone who studies leadership will understand this principle. A good leader will never avoid any problem. A good leader will face any problem. Even to their own dislike. Many times you don't like to confront a person. But if you will not say it to this person, the problem will not be solved. And the problem will be more and more serious. The third mindset. The mindset of a fool is they rely on money. In verse
19,
a feast is made for laughter, wine makes life merry, and money is the answer for everything. The third mindset of a fool is they considered money as able to solve everything. For them, money is omnipotent. With money, I can solve everything. Of course, they can enjoy the best food. They can consume the best wine. It seems that money is not all-powerful. But please remember, money should be your best servant. But money is also the worst master. In fact, money is really unreliable. 33 years ago, when I came to Philippines from Hong Kong, One Hong Kong dollar is equivalent to 3 Philippine pesos. Today, the same Hong Kong dollar is now equivalent to 6 Philippine pesos. So I lost 50% of what I own or my wealth. Here we are told that money cannot be relied upon. Even the Proverbs remind
us.
Proverbs chapter 23 verse
5.
Cast but a glance at riches, and they are gone, for they will surely sprout wings and fly off to the sky like an eagle. It turned out that money has wings, and money can fly away. Similarly, in Proverbs chapter 10, verses
1
to
19,
and we could see the portrait of a fool.
戆人的心,
a fool's heart,
戆人的手,
a fool's hand,
戆人的嘴,
a fool's mouth,
戆人的心态,
and the fool's mindset.
咱就要去面对,
how do we face this?
你看在传道书第十九二十节,
if we read Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 20,
不当酒中滚浓，不当心怀痴念, 你的房里面不当酒中
Do not revile the king even in your thoughts, or curse the rich in your bedroom, because a bird in the sky may carry your words, and a bird on the wing may report what you say. And this is how King Solomon advises us to face the fool. Whenever you see a fool, you should not criticize him. Neither should you condemn or curse him. You should not gossip about him behind your back. Because one day, what you have uttered may be spread around. And in the end, you will be attacked. May the Lord help us. As we remind ourselves, we take a look at the portrait of a fool. And let us avoid being of such. Recently, we are talking about this sermon series, The Blueprint of a Wisdom-Filled Life. Let us all be a wise person and not a fool. We should not be a fool in the midst of fools. Let us face this life with another mindset or attitude. May God help us. Let us pray. We thank God that King Solomon was such a wise person. He showed us the entire portrait of a fool and the portrait of a wise person. May God help us. For we all want to be a wise person. Allow us first to know what who is a fool.
君手所创的。
Whatever the hands will do,
君嘴所讲的。
Whatever the words the mouth will utter,
君心所想的。
Whatever thoughts the heart will think of,
都求上帝保守君。
May God protect and keep us.
圣经讲保守你的心，也叫保守一切。
Guard our hearts against all things.
好君好保守君自己的心。
We pray that we will protect and guard our hearts.
好君是一个智慧聪明的人。
And allow us to be a wise person.
感谢上帝。
We thank God.
听君的祈祷。
Listen to our prayers.
奉主的圣名。
In the name of Jesus, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
下一个礼拜，咱来看人生真多个就 unknown 未知数，咱要怎去面对人生未知、唔知影的代志。
Next Sunday, we'll be sharing with you how to face life's uncertainties and unknowns.
咱来看《传道书》第十一章。
Ecclesiastes chapter 11.
下礼拜两个沙都。
See you again next week.
God bless you.
God bless you.